dear Mum and Dad, just a quick news flash to say I've arrived in one piece. Good lodgings with a nice landlady.
Fact is, I'm just too wee bit choosy. Particularly, you see what I mean. But I'm always ready. Be prepared, as we used to say in the Girl Guides.
A bit crazy, but okay. Sort of everyone's favorite aunt. Very cozy,
very cozy, very cozy, very cozy.
I tell all my guests that to treat my house as home. Home from home, dear.
Don't let my awful sisters drag you down. Joke. Love.
It doesn't happen to be the same as mine. Then I'm afraid you're going to be a bit disturbed by what goes on. And by the way, if any of you attempt to think it's all pretty far-fetched, then you should stop and think, and ask yourself seriously whether such a thing as this could really happen. The answer is yes. Of course, even to you.
Thank you. A strike of a match to the candle that is the life of men. The tick of a clock that brings with it the withering of what is left of this organic world. Words that paint pictures like the flavours that flood my mouth at the banquets with my sisters, or the smells that appear at the burning of incense. Sometimes malodorous, but continues to keep me wanting. Stories that may or may not be true, but I never tire. In the abundance of words, we're taken to new depths every day. At the snap of wood and the raise of a hand, a story will end or continue to flourish. Such is the natural order, like the governance of me and my sisters.
Through a bush. To my right, an owl looks onto a nearby field with wide eyes and feathers as pale as the moon. Behind me, I leave only what exists in photos taken and letters written. At my feet are stones with numbers on them. I pick one up and realise they are dates. Each stone represents a day wasted. Ahead, I see pale blue flowers growing. Each flower dances with a bounce. Train rattling in the distance, echoes and vibrations. A light approaches at speed, but I feel no need to worry. I look to the sky, and shooting stars are leaving beautiful trails above my head. The train gets louder, and the lights get brighter, and all of a sudden, I wake up in a hospital bed. worry. To the sky. The train gets louder. The lights get brighter. And all of a sudden, in a hospital bed, to the sound of my heart beating.
These men instinctively pull at loose threads on their parachutes and light hell for leather. The flickers of beauty mask the endearing pain. When you arrive, if you arrive, perhaps you'll arrive like a spoke on the wheel to close this book with a flourish and a grin. Between you and I, it's really no trouble.
I'm not what I used to be. 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 I'm not what I used to be.
Now that I think about it, what hope do I have? Here I sit on a piece of stone that protrudes from my cell wall. Comfort is a distant memory. A multitude of scenarios poison my mind. But there's only one finale I approach. There's a drip that echoes like the tick of a clock, and it helps me find focus. Unfortunately, that focus is stolen. Stolen by fear that is dragged past my cell door. Vocalised anticipation that cries uncertainty. They don't know their fate any more than I do. But we've all heard the stories. What hope have when they're governed by the unscrupulous system of this court.
Now that I think about it, what hope do I have?
For a familiar face, only to be greeted by a room cold and starved of expression.
Until then, goodbye.
Thank you. Back to today, and at 4:45, the Monday edition of Blue Peter.